In this quick video, I'm going to show you how to use data validation tools from data dictionaries to make sure your data has integrity, and also I'll show you how to create relationships between data tables. Open the table customer here in our vet clinic database, and let's go right into design view. So we can do that by clicking here at the bottom right. So our first task is to make sure that the database knows that customer DOB, date of birth, is actually a date. So let's change that to a date. The customer since should also be a date time field. Let's change the customer notes, so just scroll down a little bit, to long text. Save and close the table. So if you just try and close it, it'll ask you if you want to save. Go ahead and click yes. Let's open up the table service. Here we're going to change the unit price. So here we can change the view as well on the top left. We're going to change the unit price here to currency. And we can right click and save on the tab, or as we did before, we can click the X to close and save. Let's go back into the table customer in design view and modify some of these short text fields so that they are restricted in number of characters. So if we click on the short text here, for example, for the first name, let's limit that to 15 characters. For the customer address, we'll set it to 50. The customer city, 15. The province will be 2. The postal code, we'll set that to 7. The customer phone, we'll set to 10 here. Sex, we'll actually change to customer gender, and we'll create that as a single field format. Let's take a look at the validation of this right now. So the validation rule is going to be either M or F or X for unspecified. Then our validation text will tell the users what is valid in this field. So we can write enter M or F or X. And let's go ahead and save the table. You may get this warning that some data may be lost, but it will not be, in fact, because these validation rules do not violate any of the data. So go ahead and click yes, save multiple times. Let's set a default value for the province here. So here is our data type options, and you can see default value is here. Let's set that to BC. So whenever we create a new entry, the default province for that entry will be BC. For customer since, we'll also add a default value that sets it to today's date. So when we create a new record, we will have today's date set as the default value. Now we'll use an input mask to set the pattern of characters that must be entered into a field. A wizard is provided for some standard input, and you can also build your own to represent the type of data or characters that you want entered. So we are going to use an input mask for the customer phone number, so that phone numbers are all entered in the same way. So let's click on the customer phone field, and then input mask here. The wizard is a pop-up out of these three buttons. Save the table first, yes, and we have the option for phone number right there. So go ahead and click through. We will save it without symbols. In our database, typically in a database, you do not want to save any unnecessary characters. And finish. We can also use list lookups to make sure that our data has integrity by only allowing a certain field to have restricted number of values, like a drop down or select that you might find on an online form. We're going to open up table service and change the data type of the service category. Here we're going to use the lookup wizard. So clicking on it, the drop down to select the lookup wizard. So first we need to change it to short text, make sure it's short text, and then go into the lookup wizard. So I want to type in the values here. And we'll just go ahead and type cosmetic. Oops. Using the downward arrow, diagnostic, to create another. Div and procedure. Click next. We'll leave it as the service category label, but make sure you click to limit to list so that only these list items can be entered. Click finish. And you'll see it hasn't changed here, but when we go into design view, saving the table, we can select a drop down now of the different types of services. That's the list we just created. So save and close all, save, and let's move on. Next up, we will create table lookups for the foreign keys in the appointment table. So go ahead and so we will look at the tables now in the relationship tools. So under database tools, click relationships and select all three tables. If you have additional here, you can always hide it. They're just the same table that it's showing you. We're going to just expand it here so we can see all the field names without a scroll bar. Okay, so these three tables are shown, but they're not yet linked together. We're going to create the link actually from the appointment table. So let's close this, save the layout, and let's open this in design view. So we've got two foreign keys here. We're going to choose the customer ID, and then make sure you don't change the type. We will change it to the lookup. The lookup field here, we're going to get the values from another table, right? The customer ID is being pulled in from the customer table. But in fact, we want to get a little bit more. Clicking through the wizard, we're going to select the customer name. Oh, my mouse is playing tricks on me. Okay, and then click next. And let's sort by last name and then first name. Click next. Here's a summary of what it will look like. We want to leave this checkbox on here so that we don't see the ID number. The ID number is not really important. What's important, of course, is the customer's name, especially when we're creating appointments for that customer. So we'll just leave this hidden, so checked on, and continue through to the final page. Here we're going to enable data integrity and cascade delete, meaning if I delete a customer, all of their appointments will also be deleted. Click finish. It's going to say you must save the table before relationships can be created. Yes, save. We will now do the same for the relationship between the appointment table and the service table. So back into the design view, we use the lookup wizard, and we will retrieve here the service name. We're going to hide the key column, and we're going to enable data integrity and cascade delete. Click finish, save the table. And now let's go into the database tools relationships. And we can see that the referential integrity has been set. So we can test that by double clicking on the line here and seeing that enforced referential integrity has been set with the cascade delete on. So, and you can see the type of relationship as well. Okay, save your file,